Hey everybody, Joe Goldstein with Mr. Checkout. I just got off a call I thought might be interesting to discuss. It was with a sparkling beverage line. They started locally and they were able to expand pretty rapidly in their region. So it was an interesting call. I thought you'd find it interesting. I'm going to go over the pitch and the negotiation. If you find the content interesting, if something resonates, hit the like button. I'd appreciate it. And if you want to hear more about these kind of calls, subscribe. I should be posting them every so often. But yeah, the biggest thing that perturbs me is that when I get on a call with somebody, they don't know their numbers. They don't know, you know, what their wholesale numbers are, what kind of margins it brings, what their minimum order quantity purchase requirements are. So that was really refreshing on this call, is that he knew all of his numbers off the bat. He had them all written down. He sent them to me beforehand, which really didn't help because I wasn't on my email when he sent them to me. But you know, it was nice, and I was able to keep that in the file in case I had questions later. But you know, the product was selling for a bit of a high end. It was $379 on the shelf. He had promotion dollars in there for the retailers that he was working with, which isn't really required for independent retail. So that price point could drop down to around $325 as far as an everyday sell point. And, you know, you do a 2-for-7 deal. You kind of play with it. You find what works. So the stores were able to make between 40 to 50%. Margin, which is typical. That's exactly what, you know, typically the stores look for a smaller everyday beverage. And they had margin for distributors and wholesalers. So their distributor margin was around 25%, 25 to 30, I believe he said, with volume. And the wholesale was around 20 to 22%, which makes sense because you're going to need to hire a merchandising company for another 10% on top of that. Make it up. But when bringing on a new line for a distributor, they had very reasonable MOQs. You know, they were willing to take a cut on their side of the coin. So they were willing to send out 5 cases instead of a pallet for a newer distributor to test out in their stores before purchasing the pallet MOQ that they require. But that's always a huge advantage whenever somebody's able to test before they invest, whenever they're able to try it out, make sure the market's right for the product before, you know, bringing it on board and really committing. They also had really good in-store signage. They had the static clings for the windows. They had the shelf talkers for the cooler doors. And they had a really cool suction cup display that was able to really feature the product in the cooler that they said was doing really well. And that's what kind of, they saw a big boost in their sales when they were able to put that in there, get that in your face kind of branding. And when somebody saw that, they looked a little harder and they found their product, which, you know, they didn't have the best shelving, so they were on the bottom shelf. But they saw it from the signage in the stores. They looked for it and they were able to find it, which they saw, I think they 34% increase in sales from doing that in-store signage. So you never really know, and you have to test these things. You don't know what's going to work until you test it in the store. And that was one of their biggest takeaways, was, you know, they don't know which markets are going to work for their line. So, you know, we're testing them in a New York market, a California, and Miami. We're also testing them in West Virginia to see if it's a good fit for rural market. Because a lot of the bigger distributors, they don't cover this kind of a product in smaller markets. So, you know, maybe providing that alternative, giving us something different, would be a good fit for the market. We don't know. That's why we're doing that testing. So, you know, we're initially setting them up with about 3 to 5 distributors, making sure it's the right fit for the market before expanding and hopefully taking them national. But I'd love to hear your comments below. You know, if you have a product, we'd love to hear about it. So please get back to us. We look forward to speaking with you.